Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel, and today's video is to answer lots of questions from you guys on how to tell the difference between a female and a male geese. And as you can see, here's our geese here at my back there. Today's video is a little challenging for me because I decided to use English only for this video because majority of the viewers who requested for this video were from Australia and Canada. So I decided to use English aside from adding subtitle in it. Okay, let's jump to our video. These two geese are male and female, but they are almost similar at first glance, aren't they? But that's what you should know, especially when you are a beginner in raising geese. And they already know which is husband and wife are. But as a beginner, is it easy to find out? Well, sometimes not. I have some tips here on how to figure that out more easier, but I'm not sure if it will work on all breeds. You may check if you see this in your pet geese. Number one, gander has a thinner and longer neck. As you can see, the one on the right side is the gander and the left side is the female. And it's very easy to see that. Next is herder callings. Callings are one of the most basic ways to find out the gender of a pet. The male has a slower high-pitched honk. That's loud. Oh, that's loud. Goodbye. Answer. Go answer. Answer your husband. Answer your husband. He is calling for you. He is calling for you. Go answer. So female makes a hink noise, lower pitch and faster than the males. So that's how they're callings. The female honk like this, honk, honk, and the gander says honk, honk, honk. Okay, number three. Notice that the undercarriage hangs lower for a female goose than a male goose. We can check it here. The undercarriage of the female goose is lower compared to the gander or the male goose. And that is very easy to see. And finally, we are going to do the vent sexing, which is for me the hardest thing to do, but the most accurate way to determine the gender of our geese. Why did I say that it's hard to do this? Because the male goose is strong, and you have to hold him really tight because his claws might hurt you when doing the process. You need to position the neck under your armpit like this, so that he can't resist that much, because this gander is really strong, so you must be very careful. Then you need to find the vent, and when you see that, you have to use your hand to push him like that. You have to push it a bit hard, and when you see the small white color that looks like a little painted one, little thing here, right here, this one. Okay, wait a second, we will repeat it. Okay, if you see the little white little thing here, or the very pointed little thing here, right here in the upper part, is the male reproductive organ, or it we have already checked and found the male reproductive organ of the gander or the male goose. Okay, just for the record, we are going to check the vent of this one, but this is our female breeder geese, so as usual and same process, you have to hold the both legs and position the neck under your armpit to avoid it from resisting and hurting you on its claws. Like what we did to the gander, you have to find the vent and see its reproductive organ, so you have to push it a bit harder. If you can see the pointed little thing in the upper part there, but obviously we did not see a male reproductive organ because this is a war female geese. So that's it. Those are our tips on how to determine the gender of our goose. I hope this video helped us, especially those fellow geese lovers there that are newbies. And if you find this video helpful, you can give it a like, and I will appreciate it when you press the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so that you will be updated when we are going to upload a new videos. So that's all. Happy farming to all. Bye. Bye-bye.